For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Top 20 Films from your Sample Files folder. I'm going to begin this lesson by inserting a new column to the left of column A. You learned how to do this in lesson 3.1. I select all of column A by clicking in the column header, then right-click in the selected cells and select Insert from the shortcut menu. Next, I'm going to move the text in cell B1 into cell A1 using drag and drop. You learnt how to do this in lesson 3.4. So I click in cell B1, hover over the border of the selected cell, and then click and drag to the left to move the text. Next, I'm going to apply some styles to some of the cells, using the skills you learned in lesson 4.9. First, I'll apply the title style to cell A1. To do that, I click Home on the ribbon in the Styles group, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery, and then I click on the title style. Now I'll apply a style to the header row, row 3. So I select all of row 3 by clicking on the row header button, then once again home on the ribbon, styles, cell styles, to bring up the cell styles gallery, and this time I'll apply the heading 2 style. I can't see all of this worksheet on the screen at the moment, so I think I'll hide the ribbon to give myself a little more space. To do that, I click the Ribbon Display Options button at the top right of the screen and then select Auto Hide Ribbon. And I can now see the entire worksheet. I think a nice style should be applied to cell D25. So I'll click on cell D25. To bring the ribbon back, I'll click at the top of the screen. Then the Home tab on the ribbon, Styles, Cell Styles again, to bring back the Cell Styles gallery, and this time I'll apply the Heading 4 style. Now I'm going to type some text into column A. I'll begin with cell A4, and I'm going to type over 400 million. Now I'll type some text into cell A12. Here I'll type over 350 million. And now I'll type some text into cell A17. Here I'll type over 300 million. Now I'll make column A slightly wider, so that all of the text in the columns visible. You learned how to do this in lesson 2.9. So I hover over the intersection of the row headers for column A and column B until I see the resize cursor shape, and then click and drag slightly to the right. Now I'm going to merge cells A4 to A11, using the skills you learned in lesson 4.6. So I select cells A4 to A11, click at the top of the screen to bring back the ribbon, Home tab on the ribbon, and in the alignment group, Merge and Center drop down, and Merge Cells. And you can see that cells A4 to A11 have now become one big cell. Now I'll do the same for cells A12 to A16. So I'll select A12 to A16, once again bring back the ribbon and merge cells. And I'll do the same for cells A17 to A23. First select the cells, bring back the ribbon and merge cells. Now I'm going to rotate the text in the merged cells through 90 degrees. I'll begin by selecting the three merged cells, A4, A12 and A17, bring back the ribbon, Home tab, Alignment group, and notice that there's an orientation button. And if I click on the orientation button, one of the options is Rotate Text Up. I'm going to click Rotate Text Up now, and you can see that the text has now rotated within each of the merged cells. I'd like the text in each of the merged cells to appear in the very centre of the cell. So I'm going to set the horizontal and vertical alignment to middle, using the skills you learned in lesson 4.5 and 4.7. So I select the three merged cells, then Home tab on the ribbon, and in the Alignment group, I'll click Middle Align and Center Align, and the text is now perfectly in the center of each merged cell. I'm now going to apply a style to each of the three merged cells. So once again, with the three merged cells selected, I'll click Home tab on the ribbon in the Styles group, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery, and I'm going to apply the Heading 4 style. So I click Heading 4. Next, I'm going to auto-fit cells A4 to A17 so that they're just wide enough for the text within them. To do this, I'll use the skills that you learned in Lesson 2.9. I select the three merged cells, bring back the ribbon, and in the Cells group, Format, and Auto-fit Column Width. And the cells are now the perfect width for their contents. Now I'm going to apply some styles to cells A4, A12, and A17. First of all, cell A4. So I select cell A4, bring back the ribbon, Home tab Styles, Cell Styles, to bring up the Cell Styles gallery, and I'm going to apply the 40% Accent 3 style. So I click 40% Accent 3, and the styles applied to the cell. Now at cell A12, once again the Cell Styles gallery, and this time I'll apply the 40% Accent 6 style. Then cell A17, once again the Cell Styles gallery, and this time the 40% Accent 2 style. Now let's rotate the text in row 3. So I'll begin by making room for rotated text by making row 3 about 3 times its normal height. So I'll hover the cursor over the intersection of the row headings 3 and 4, and then click and drag down to make the row a lot taller. Now I'm going to rotate the text in row 3 through 90 degrees. So I select all of row 3 by clicking the row 3 row header, click at the top of the screen to bring back the ribbon, the Home tab, the Alignment group, and the Orientation button. And this time I'm going to choose Angle Counterclockwise. So I'll click Angle Counterclockwise, and you can see that the text has been rotated 45 degrees within each cell. Well, I can see that Year isn't aligning with the contents of column C very well, so I'll widen column C just a little so that things look a little better. Well, I've now finished working on this worksheet, so I think I'll bring back the ribbon. To do that, I click on the Ribbon Display Options button and click Show Tabs and Commands, the normal way of working with Excel. All that remains now is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Top 20 Films 1. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 4.23, Rotate Text.